techno update. Subscribe now.
Samsung Galaxy Note 7 review. Design and build. When it comes to design, Samsung has struck a nice balance of retaining the look of the Note series while bringing the style of the Galaxy S7. In this case, particularly the Galaxy S7 Edge, as the new Note 7 has the dual edge curved screen as standard. What's quite amazing here is that the Note 7 doesn't feel like a phablet despite the screen size remaining at 5.7 inches. It's not much bigger than the S7 Edge, and the device feels more manageable than ever, which is very impressive. This slab of metal and glass looks and feels great, although be wary of the rear cover as the slippery glass means the device is likely to slide out of your pocket when sitting down or make its way slowly off the edge of a sofa arm. Screen. Sticking to tradition, the Galaxy Note 7 has a 5.7-inch display, so users of previous Note phones will feel right at home. Despite rumors of a 4 or even 6K resolution, Samsung has sensible stuck to Quad HD, 1440x2560, which it uses on the S7 handsets. It's still a gorgeous display using the firm's favored Super AMOLED technology with the added bonus of the dual edge. It works in the same way as the S7 Edge, so you have a subtle curve on either side, unlike the 2014 Galaxy Note Edge, which had a large curved section on one side. As you can see below, the screen looks like a glossy magazine and the lack of bezels makes it look great. Performance. Bringing the Note range up to speed, quite literally, the Note 7 is powered by the same processor found in the Galaxy S7, that's Samsung's own Exynos 8890, which, in the S7, we found more than capable. In some markets the phone comes with Qualcomm's Snapdragon 820, but we're dealing with the 8890 here in the UK. The Note 7 has 4GB of RAM despite rumors of 6GB, which means the OnePlus 3 remains in its exclusive club. Storage. When it comes to storage, the Galaxy Note 7 comes with 64GB as standard and retains the microSD card slot for adding more, up to 256GB. A good move since the Note 5 didn't have one, and nor did the Galaxy S6, which wasn't met with gratitude from users. Battery life. It was something of a shock that Samsung didn't make the switch to USB-C on the Galaxy S7 phones, but has now done so with the Note 7. The port is reversible, making it easier to plug in, but also offers faster charging and, in theory, data transfer rates faster than USB 3.0. In our charging test, using the supplied adaptive fast charging charger, we found the Note 7 took 1 hour and 15 minutes to go from 0 to 100%. That's not bad considering the large 3500 mAh capacity. In our real-world test, the Note 7 battery life is reasonable but perhaps not as stamina-tastic as you might hope with the 3500 mAh battery. With a normal and varied usage, we found that after 24 hours, the Note 7 has less than 15% juice left.